And there I am, finally.
Plays it kind of goal. Chorski scored a little while ago for Team Green. Scores 1-1. So I'm a bit late on the commentary and on the video.
Had to get involved in a bit of a different part of the production. So here we are. Something to call action, guys. I don't know. There's Scavo in front. Got his pick, hot to pick by Price. Pass out over the blue line. The zone is clear. Picked up by Walz. That's Wes Walz, yes. We are here at Minnesota Warriors annual NHL alumni game. And we're going to get a penalty, apparently. So we have Minnesota Warriors here. Both green and white teams are playing. They're although not really against each other, per se. And each side has some NHL alumni playing, so our Warriors had the awesome experience of playing with some NHL guys today. We got names on our jerseys today. That helps me a lot. Eggerson gets it back on the corner, fires it in, cleared wide. Gordie Roberts, Hall of Famer, taking the puck around the backside. Passes it clear of Scavo, who is doing his best to be a pest. Swaps it away from Price up the Walz, who dumps it in the corner for Joel. Takes it around the front, being pestered by Gordie, who clears it free and up and clear. Darby Hendrickson with a puck right up the middle, takes a wrister just wide. Puck out the center ice, Gordie Roberts clears it, looks to send it into the zone. Passes it up, Steller intercepts a pass of the green team, bounces it off and heads up the ice. Chris McAlpin with the pass, sends it across ice. Team Green on offense, picking it up in the corner. Dumps it, centering pass. Mandovich there, off the pole and in. Second goal on Mark Stamford. He's a bit ticked off, right off the post and down. And it's 2-1 Green team. Apologize for my cough. I don't have a cough button like a fancy radio guys do. Puck, Sam Kelly with a full head of speed. He is fast, one of the fastest Warriors. And we get an icing. Cleared up the ice. Sam Kelly trying to match some speed, put a little bit of pressure on these NHL guys. If you're watching this recording and you haven't seen the Warriors before, Minnesota Warriors are a hockey team based out of Bonin, Minnesota, populated entirely by military veterans of a disability related to their service. Some of these guys have played hockey at a pretty good level. High school hockey is pretty good here in Minnesota. A lot of guys played in high school. There's a shot in front. I think it's Kevin Qualley took the shot, bounced off the front, centers it across, and just clear. Who's that? It was Nelson. Justin Nelson of the Warriors trying another shot. Anyway, Team Green now in control. Passed up to Kelly. Passes it up for Brian Bonin. Kelly plants in front. Missed it. Centering pass. Nobody home. Team White trying to get in control. And there he is. I can't read the name on the jersey. I can't see it from this high. And there's a shot up and saved by, I think it's Ulmer in goal on the other side. I don't know what the goal is going off for. We didn't have a goal. Find the net around the corner. Chris Price keeping it in the zone. Anthony Keller being hanging out in front looking for an opportunity. Now heads for the boards for the loose puck. Loses his footing a bit. Anyway, white team still in control. Attempted a centering pass, and Tom Chorski was there to intercept that. Passes it up in the corner. Centering pass. And a good opportunity. An excellent save by Mark Samford. Another centering pass. Flairmon's there. Covered up by Samford. Good job. After what he thought was a soft goal on that last shot off the post, Samford made a pretty couple of good saves there. Excellent job, young man. We'll have a face-off in the corner here with 13:25 left in the first. Anyway, face-off going. I'm going to turn my head for a second. Chris Price there to clear it off. Held in by Egerstrom. Centered across and just wide. Whoa, that's a hard hit on this corner there, covered up by Samford. Scavo got face to face with a member of the white team there. It's one of the morals, I think. Both got looking the other way, hit each other pretty hard. Never mind, it's all good today. Yeah, McAlpin checking in for Team White. White controls the puck back to McAlpin, over to Gordie Roberts. Passes it over to McAlpin, up and free. Intercepted by Green, pushed back. Skates in front, with wrister just wide on Samford. Furness gets a goal. Furness, one of the newest Warriors, just came home from the sandbox a few months ago. Playing previously with the 194 Cavalry Crazy Troop team, whom the Warriors played a few months ago up in Cloquet. But he lives down here and said, you know, this Warrior team's got something going on. I want to be a part of it too. And we welcome him aboard. Gets a goal on Mark. It's 3-1 Green. Darby Henriksen intercepts that, knocks it down, passes over to Dietzick, centers it for Toomey, and goal. Toomey getting on the board for White, and just like that, the two-goal lead is back down to one. Sean Toomey evens it up. I'm going to see if I got my roster. I had one earlier, and I got busy on stuff. And I don't know what happened to all the stuff I had. There it is. This will help me out a little bit. Anyway, Darby picks off the pass, sends it up for Dietzick, who centers it over for Toomey, and just like that, two goals in a row. Same play from right to left. And it's 3-3. I had a feeling we were going to see a whole lot of goals here today. The one last season, I believe, was like 8-6. This one looks like it's going to be a little more. Anyway, White's in control of the face-off again. Darby passes it back. Anyway, had his pocket picked there. It's Brian Bonin. He's looking for somewhere to go with it. Looks for Dean John. Pass was behind him. He couldn't pick it up. Anyway, Sean Toomey's got it. Drops it back for Darby. Takes a wrister from the corner. Knocked free by Homer. Anyway, Green up into the zone. A wrister from the blue line. Or a big slap shot. I said wrister. What's wrong with me? Sam Kelly took a big windup. That one ripped,
and wide. Both teams changing up here.
Some new folks in.
And we get a stoppage of the play. We'll have a face-off in the end. I think the puck went up over the side there. Looking out at the crowd, we probably got, you know, a good 300 or 400 people in here today. Raising money for Minnesota Warriors hockey. And there's this goal off the face-off. Brian Bonin. Face-off went to him. He just took a shot, and that was it. 4-3 now green. Back out to center ice where a face-off goes. An assist by Joe Scavel of Blaine is the call. And a green team in control up around the corner, clears it out of the zone. Team White, I can't figure. It's only jersey without a name on it, and I have to figure out who that is in a minute. There's White taking along the blue line is Payne. Tom Youngin's got and took it away from him. Brian Bonin playing doing some good stick work there. Centers it up. Canavan couldn't get a hold of it. Playing back there, out to the point. But White takes control. Puck dumped around the outside, around the boards. That's like Flairmon coming up. Tries to center it, intercepted by White, and centered off and taken away again. And there's Tom Chorski taking the pass, dancing around, loses control of the puck. Canavan had it. There's a little bit of a scrum in front of the net. Mark Stanford covers it up. A little bit of pushing and shoving going on here between some Warrior faithful. Green control of the faceoff off to the top, just wide. I think he got deflected. Anyway, right out in front for Chorski, who sent it back to the side and covered up by Marks again. Big save by Stanford. He's going to be upset at himself for giving up 4 goals here, but he's doing a pretty good job. He's made some good saves. Remember, these are NHL talent out here playing too. I guess Tom Chorski centers it out, sends it out to the point. Goes over the head of Stanford. Out to the point, knocked in. Highly pass intercepted by White in control. Justin Nelson tries to back it up. Couldn't make it. Didn't find anybody. We're going to have a battle in the corner and back behind the net. Puck brought up by Walls, I believe. We had an opportunity there, and Mark Stanford just robbed him. Mark should gain some confidence out of that. A couple of NHLers just came at him, and he shut him down. Anyway, team captain Andy Qualley had it, tried to play it along, got it knocked down by a pest named Furnace. Lankinson with a puck now, tries to send it out to Eggerstrom, intercepted by by Jerry Page. And a one-on-one, and a goal scored. Yeah, Sam, it's Andrew Keller with the goal. Couldn't come up with it. Andrew Keller on a one-on-one breakaway. Jukes left and right. We got a 4-4 tie.
But still 8:50 left in the first. Anyway, Lankinson's there, tried to pick up the puck, passes it off to the top, and the zone gets cleared. Brad Maxwell with a puck back across the ice. And there's Keller again with the puck, looking for another one, bounces it right off the goalie. And Ulmer has to cover up. Jerry Page lost his footing. Jerry's still an active duty member of the Minnesota National Guard. Lives out of Brooklyn Park. Playing music pretty loud. That'll make Google ticked off at me when I upload this to YouTube later. Anyway, pass up to Steller, trying to get past the NHL talent defenseman there. Sam Kelly tried a narrow angle shot, missed it behind the net. Team White hanging around the backside of the offensive zone. Trying to get a break here, trying to find it. Centering pass from behind the net was good. Sammy's there with the, trying to get the puck. Sammy Kornick had her puck pocket pick, but Sam comes up with a head of steam. Gets around Mark and misses. They had their open net wrapper out and missed it. He won't hear about that. Anyway, there's Darby Hendrickson looking for a top shelf and has it. Darby Hendrickson with a goal for the White. And White team now has the lead, 5-4. Looks like 7:12 left in the first period. Like that. I didn't see who got that one. Might have been Hendrickson again. See if I can hear it say an eavesdrop. I don't know. I didn't hear the announcement. Oh, Zizek with the goal. Anyway, that was Youngins with the puck, looking for someone to send it to. Dean Jan taking his time getting up into the zone. And I think the play was just whistled offside. Zizek got a bit anxious. White's in control. Brian Bonin got it though, stole it. He's by himself and scores. I think that surprised Mark. He didn't think the shot was coming that early. Team White back at it here after my coughing fit. Going back at it, clears it out. Price keeps it in. Has it taken away by Tom Chorski. He looks for some help. He's got Scott Canavan who knocks it in. Under Mark Stanford's stick. So Scott Canavan assists Tom Chorski. Oh, you face off back, Green in control. Scott Canavan takes, plays it up around the corner. John Conrad was there, had sent it up, but here's Gabe Thomas coming up with a steep, full head of speed. Looked for a shot, had to get a slow gear, and that was a goal. That one counted, I think. Kind of a slow roller, and Mark, or, and Ulmer kind of lost track of it there. Are they going to call it a goal or not? No, I think they waved it off. We're going to have the face off right there. I don't know. I thought it was good for a second. Anyway. It's Gordie Roberts with the puck, Hall of Famer. Centers it out, intercepted by Green. Brad Maxwell is there to knock it away. Went out for Dave, or for Andrew Qualley, took a shot from the blue line clear. There he is, looking for some help. Sends it out to Gordie Roberts. He sends it into the offensive zone. Eggerstrom was there to pass it along the boards. Qualley went back to retrieve it, sends it around again. Come up to the point here. This is Kevin Benshoof working with Wes Walz. Loses the puck. Cleared out to Maxwell. Sends it over to Benshoof, to Eggerstrom, to Walz. Again, Maxwell there between the legs pass. He got Sam Kelly back there with it. Centers it across. Knocked back. And finally clear to the zone. There's Gabe Thomas looking for some help, centers it. But the pass was a bit errant. Donnie Morrell couldn't get a stick on it. Back to now, centered across. Gabe was there to take out the trash and missed the puck. Boy, he was there for the backside goal and couldn't get a stick on the puck to handle the pass. Steller's got the puck around the side here, looking for somewhere to go with it. Puck gets fired out of the zone, and we're going to get an icing. 3:41 left in the first, and yes, 7-6. Offensive festival. Almost missed a goal there by Green. Hey, Maxwell is there, sends the puck in the center. And puck is plays whistle dead, and that'll be it. Try it again, 3:09. Puck is managed. That's Maxwell. Former North Star Dan Mandish, that was. And Tom Youngins with a puck, playing between a couple of white defenders, has it cleared out. Brian Bonin back to retrieve it. Kevin Qualley trying to be the pest. The Silver Fox on the ice now for Team White, one of our elder warriors, Tommy Johnson. Vietnam veteran. Young Qualley on the ice as well. There's Anthony Keller looking for another goal. Covered up finally. Had a little fun with each other. Good save that time by Elmer. The puck sat on the ice in front of him for what looked like about 8 minutes. 2:17 left in the first. And the green team finally in control. Coming up into the offensive zones, Brian Bonin passes the puck up for Dean Jan, who lost his feet there in front of the goalie. Judy Van Hooris on the ice, plays it up into the corner. Anthony Keller had it, was looking for somewhere to go, had his pocket picked by Jim Flairbaum. The pass hit Sammy right in the skate. A little shot by Sammy, stopped by Sammy Kornick with a shot, stopped by Mark Stanford, who covered that up. So face off to the right of Team White goalie Tom Chorski, trying to get it. Anthony Keller was there to take the puck away. That's a nice feather in his cap. Centers it up for Morrell, who couldn't handle it. A little shot, puck's knocked straight up in the air, but well out of threatening range. Pass up into green zone. Sent up in front of the ice by Canavan. Brad Maxwell looking to wind up in front, sends one up in front of the net. Chris Price was there to stop it. It's Canavan looking for another long shot. Oh, look what I found. Mark looks surprised to have caught that one. It's like he never saw the puck and it just hit him right in the glove. But every save counts the same, right, Mark? T. White in control. That was Andy Qualley with the puck, hanging it up the ice now, looking for something to do with it. Tried to pass it up to Hendrickson and couldn't do it. Too many people in the way. Chorski with a puck, takes it across the blue line, looking for something to do with it. Just skating around, dancing a bit, being pestered by Hendrickson. Sends it around the backside, and here comes Andy Qualley with a puck, passes it up for Hendrickson. Dumps it up for Diedzik, takes it across the ice. And there was Hendrickson on the other side, sends a puck right in the middle of Phil Elmer. Or Mike Elmer. Why did I say Phil? I think I know my own guys. And that'll do it for the first period. Score is 7-6. You'll see it pop up here in a second on the screen, I think. It's 7-6. I know. There it comes. 7-6. We'll be back with the second period in a few minutes. Thanks for watching Cheap Seats. Back for period number two. Green figured out who's in net. That's going to be Scott Anderson. The NHL alumni. In net for Team White now is Al Lindgren. Here's Sam Kelly winding up and missed. Comes out, fed up front. Sam Kelly had a chance, couldn't get a stick on it again. Brian Bonin fed him nicely. Back with Green, fresh seat of ice. Looks pretty down there. And there's Sam Kelly. Looking for something, wrister right into Al Lindgren, who dropped it and had to jump on top of it. Hi there.
Good shot?
Oh yeah, we're doing good work. Not what I wanted to do, but we're doing it. because I had to do that stuff down there. I couldn't get my stuff set up to go live, so. We're just here, and I'm talking into it, stream of thought into this microphone. It is what it is. Face off to the left. Sam Kelly was there, had a chance backhand, but the puck bounced right over top of Lindgren. Lucky shot for Team White. Anyway, there's Kevin Qualley. One of three Qualleys on the team for the Warriors. Hanging it up the ice. There he is, taking it again. Sends it up for Gabe Thomas, who wasn't really expecting it, apparently. Played around the boards, and there is Chris McAlvin. I hope that's right. Yeah, Chris McAlvin of Roseville. Stuff here. Line change for White, hand whistle dead. Net got knocked off the magnet. Not clear of the zone. Faced off in the offensive zone for Green. Cleared back. Lost control of it. Passed up for Lankinson. I never say his name right. Anyway, Joe Scavel was there. Tried to get a stick on it. Couldn't do it. Bouncing puck. Still free in front of the net. And finally cleared free by White. There's Kalska. Passes it back to the defender and up to the offensive zone. Centered pass. Shot was wide by Morrell. And here's Lackinson coming up the ice again. Takes it across, looking for someone to pass it to. Shoots one wide. And back behind the net in the offensive zone. Morrell just couldn't catch up with that. Got a good puck in there, get a good pass. Finally got there, he couldn't. Pass from Sammy Kornick over to Chorski, who feeds her back on a give and go. Good shot there by Sammy. Of course, sends it right back into Al. How are you? I'm with the Warriors, so.
Okay. Is your coach going to be able to, like, see this?
Yes. Watch the Warriors Facebook thing, and I'll post it up there when I can.
Oh, great, thanks.
Thank you. Interested fans in what I'm doing and where they can watch this later. Where they can make fun of my semi-pro camera skills and semi-pro play-by-play skills and semi-pro color commentary skills. Semi-pro production skills. Anyway, Team Green trying hard to not be offsides. Everyone's standing on the blue line as the puck come across. Again, puck's still there. Sammy's trying to get a shot off. Ben Shoup is there trying to keep control of it. This puck's just bouncing all over. Tom Chorski behind the net. Finally, Andy Qualley takes it and passes it up for Payne. It takes a shot. Kind of surprised Scott Anderson with it. Luck centered out and taken away. Pass up to Youngins, who bounces it up. Looks like Green's trying to complete a line change. A bit of confusion behind the play. Anyway, so here's Wes Walz coming along the boards with the puck. So lost control of it as he spun there, taken away by Andy Qualley. Puck comes up into the White offensive zone. Shot back clear, icing's waved on. Hey, Darby Hendrickson on the ice. And the other Hendrickson on the ice. it's got Kahneman with it, trying to take it up, passes it ahead. The shot fired from the blue line. Tom Youngin's looking for a shot right into the middle of Warriors team president and Al Lincoln. Navy veteran who celebrated the birthday of the Navy's little brothers, the United States Marine Corps, yesterday. And passing back and forth out to the point, over to Walz, up to the corner for Pete Staley, who lets one loose. Al turns that away. There's Pete. Off here to the left, there's Jason Steller with Hendrickson for Team White. Walz has got it. He's looking for somewhere to go. Feeds it in for Al, who looked a little surprised. Anyway, Walz feeds it out for Florimone. Over to Youngin, still loose in front. Bouncing puck, and Dean Jatton couldn't get a hold of it. He had an open net with a goalie on his face. Couldn't hit it. Anyway, there's Darby with it by himself. Centers it out for Morrill. And we got a goal. You guys have a little fun with each other still. But anyway, Donnie was there. The puck got behind Ulmer, lost track of it. Morrill was there for the goal. Or they wave it off. Looks like they waved it off for knocking the goal up. Net off first. Thought the puck was in. Anyway, Green in control at the faceoff. Brian Bonin's got the puck. Stops, passes it up for Flairmont, who comes up with a full head of speed. Drops it off for Steller. Up for the goal, and that's it. How's the slushy? Good? Where's my change? My daughter's trying to charm me out of not giving the change back. Oh, you bought candy. I see how it is. Thank you. Here, you have that one. I'll eat this one. What? What?
He swears a lot.
Well, so does your dad. My daughter's tattletaling on someone else's kids around here who apparently swear a lot. Oh, we're the kids of soldiers and sailors. We're going to swear a lot. Life in the cheap seats here. Anyway, puck's free in front of Anderson. Passes it across. There's Brad Maxwell to pick up the puck. Flips it up into the zone. There's Furness. Shoots a shoot. Gets a shot wide of Lindgren. Gordie Roberts gets it. Sends one up to Kevin Folley, who winds up wide. It's Furness again, trying to pass the puck up and it, up and out of the zone. And there's Sam Kelly. Deflected wide by Algren, up high off the glass. Kelly still got it, looking for something to do. Passes it to the center and back across to Mattson, who gets tangled up there with Keller. Anyway, loose puck gets knocked over in front of Al, who sends it around an opposing player. Gordie Roberts passes the puck up to out of the zone, just enough to clear. There now, and Bonin's looking for something to do. Comes up the middle of the ice, tries to pass it over to Kelly, who apparently didn't know what the play was called. Pass just out of reach of Gabe Thomas. Into the corner now. Doing a little dancing out there with Mandich. Green and White still there, and there's Gabe Thomas looking for a goal. And who is there with it? Kevin Qualley was there scoring on the former pro, Scott Anderson, to make it 8-6, White. Scott Anderson, formerly played with the Janesville Jets. Not an NHL team, but at any rate, he's here with the NHL alumni. So we're going to call him a pro. Anyway, Tony Laxton comes up with the puck. He's got Benchouf with him. Puck was ahead. Play was onside for a minute. Still is. Lankins has got the puck taken away by Morrill. But that only lasted for a second. Passed it up for Benchouf, who lost it. For Okalska. Skating in circles, keeping the puck in. Poked away. Poke check to clear the zone. Sean Toomey's got it. Lackinson was the guy with the poke check knocking it away. Anyway, there was Benchouf with the pass. Couldn't handle it. Engel took a little spill. Kind of bumped into Staley, I think. Anyway, that was a goal. Scored by that young man right there. That's Kalska with the goal, I believe. That was Kalska I was pointing it at anyway. Hope you got the goal. 9-6, Team White. And Wes Walz has the puck into the zone. Hits the post. He had lingering beat, but the puck hit the post and clear. I think Al thought it was in. Payne and Yuggins getting a little bit of pushing and shoving. On the blue line. I think we're going to see another part of the show here soon. Anyway, Walz got the puck behind the net, looking for something to do with it. Back and forth, passes it back for Bonin, who sets it up for a shot right off of Al. It's a good play. Yuggins got it again. Over to the other side, as it for Chorski, who missed the wide open goal. Scott Canavan missed it. Al was out of position, couldn't make it. Scanavan with the deflection again, still on top of it is Al. Excellent series by Al Lindgren. And part luck for Al Lindgren. Got caught out of position, Green missed it. Made the big goals when he could, or big saves when he needed to. Hey, Chorski there with the faceoff. Is it taken away by Payne? Skates it up towards the blue line, taken away by Walz. Makes an abrupt stop, looks for something to do. Centers it out, nobody home. Knocked away, Hornick loses her feet. Canavan, once again, can't handle the pass. Anyway, Green trying to keep the pressure on. There's Wes Walz, speed Sammy, who wound up and missed. She was in a good position, could have had it. Green had pulled the goalie. They had six members up in the offensive zone. They were going with running time. Now we're down to just 8 seconds left in the period, and I think we're going to be done. That'll do it for period number two. It's 9-6. And we'll be back with period three shortly. All right, coming back now, period number three. Going to 15 minutes for this one, and probably running time. It's already 5:30. Loose all the way down the length of the ice. Your goalies now, I believe, are Conrad for Green and David Qualley for White. I'll look up the Green here in just a second. And
like Jim Flaremont was right there trying to put a shot on net and couldn't quite make it in there. Just missed it wide. And indeed, John Conrad there. How you doing, sir?
Doing good. Just seeing what you're up to.
What's that?
See what you're up to. Are you streaming live right now?
I'm not live. I couldn't get set up in time to go live today. I had some other stuff to do last minute, so I couldn't quite get set up enough. But normally I would have been live. This is just going to be an archive. Yeah, this is going to be just an archive. Being my play-by-play and amateur-style camera work all at the same time. Gordie Roberts with the puck, taking it up, drops it off for Hendrickson. He's looking for something else to go. Centers it, but taken away by Team Green. Roberts again keeps it in zone. Across to Sean Toomey. We caught Conrad right in the pad. Kind of lost it there. Anyway, Conrad getting a good play. It was a quick pass across the center.
Are they recording you? When you're speaking?
Oh, yeah. I got microphone right up here. Piece of candy in my mouth now. Maybe that'll help me from coughing. Uh-oh. By himself, Sam Kelly. Andy Qualley, advantage. Sam Kelly. But now he just made Dave angry. He's like the Incredible Hulk of goalies. He's iffy until he's, you know, score a goal on him. That's what he always says anyway. He's not a shutout goalie. Anyway, there's Kelly again. Not this time, says Andy Qualley. Kelly with a puck, trying to get around there. He's got a bit of a rivalry with Andy Qualley. Anyway, puck comes up. That's Furness with the puck. Sends it around wide. Matson couldn't keep it in. Mandich gets it, brings it into the zone. He's got Dean Jan with him, heads to the center. Benchuk gets up in front, tries a shot. Just deflected wide into the corner. Andy Qualley finds a Nelson. Justin Nelson, who comes up the ice into the zone. He's got Hendrickson with him. Loses his speed, trying to take a shot. Hook my way to Kowalska. There's Andy Qualley with a shot. Deflected wide before it got the net. Again, pushed back into the corner. Gabe Thomas had a head of steam coming up. Couldn't handle the puck. Just misplayed it. Anyway, but there's Kevin Qualley now. Chasing it with Gabe Thomas still on the ice. Puck's free up in front of the white net. Uh-oh. And Dave Qualley just lost his stick. They're going to find another stick for Dave to use. And we got a goal in the other end while it was a bit distracted there. Looks like Keller got on the scoring board that time. Let's see who it was. Yep, so Anthony Keller got the goal. And that's Keller with the puck again, drops it off the other side. Scavo was there to intercept that pass. Mikulska gets it, takes it to the zone for White. Drops it back for Kevin Qualley. Puck goes straight in the air over the goalie's head and over the net, sitting down in the corner. I think Keller did a great job there getting a hold of that puck. Tom Chorski was cherry picking.
Yeah, I said it. Chorski was cherry picking. He's got the puck now, one-on-one with Dave Qualley. Up in net, gives it to Sammy, who sends the puck towards the net, deflected away by Dave. They're trying pretty hard to get a goal for Sammy. Putting the puck in her hand, giving the puck on her stick as soon as they can, every time they can. Oh, boy. All right, back up the center ice. There's Kalska looking for somewhere to go. Head Gabe Thomas. Pass went between his skates. There's Wes Walz. He's distinctive in his striped breezers. Anyway, there's Chorski. Deflected wide by Qualley. We've seen that a few times, I think, over the years. Dave Qualley actually plays on a league with Tom Chorski down in Bloomington. So I'm sure he's made that save a few times and missed that one a few times. Anyway, Green's got it again. There's Chorski with Walz in the middle. Oh, what a heck of a save there by Qualley. I think Chorski and Walz are going to wish they had that back. Chorski hit Walz. Walz backhanded it up there, and the puck went just bounced high and all over the place and couldn't quite figure out how to get in. Dave found the puck and knocked it down. Anyway, there's Eggerstrom with the puck up on the point. Tries a cross-ice pass, intercepting. There's Gordie Roberts coming up the ice with the puck. Passes it down to Payne, who backhands it towards the net. Conrad knocks it free. Here's Scott Canavan with his team. One-on-one and stonewalled by Qualley. Hey, Qualley is arguably the top defender on Team White for the Minnesota Warriors. You'd say arguably, because occasionally Al Lindgren stands on his head, plays one hell of a game, makes us think he's number one. Danny White, Bill B. So Brad Maxwell on the ice takes it, sends the puck up all the way up front. Good defensive job by David Qualley that time. Shut down a 2-on-1. It was Scott Canavan there with Ryan Bonin. Judy Van Hooris takes the puck, tries to get free, can't do it. Eggerstrom was there to knock the puck away. Puck was up into the nets, and we'll get a faceoff. Minutes now in the third period. Team White leads 10-7. I don't have a scoreboard up. Probably won't have one in the archives either. Heck of a play that time by Canavan, stopping the cross ice pass. Oh, he can't get back to that. Keep control of it. Get up into the offensive zone. Team White in control. Payne takes it, sends it over to Hendrickson. Unfortunately, got it out of the offensive zone where Jason Stuller was there, being a good pest. So anyway, there's Payne again. Takes the puck off the center, passed over to Hendrickson, off of Conrad. Excuse me. Madsen has the puck for Team Green, trying to keep it in the zone. Sam Kelly's there, gets to it, but all right over to one of the 14s. I think that was Hendrickson. Anyway, White's more interested in changing up than being on the ice. They only got two guys out there playing. Flairmont over to Kelly, shut down by Qualley. Puck still bouncing around free. Finally into the corner. White's finally got all their players out on the ice. Falska has the puck, passes it up ice. Where Sean Toomey had it and just kind of sat around a bit. Decided to take a late shot. Anyway, Sam Kelly breaks free, heads up the ice. He's got a little bit of help with Lankinson, but sends it up high. Puck goes free around the corner. Kelska with a puck, passes it up the ice for Toomey. Sits on the left. Who dropped it back for Tom Johnson, who couldn't handle it. And here comes Youngins, stonewalled by Dave Qualley. Anyway, Gordie Roberts winds up, fakes it, takes it behind the net. He's looking for somewhere to go with it. And there was Andy Qualley with a good shot, but couldn't find the net with it. Passes up to his brother, Kevin Qualley. Crossed the ice for Toomey. Couldn't handle it. And back to the point. Gordie Roberts lost it. White's got to clear the zone now. Sends it back for Qualley. Passes it up to the other Qualley. Along the boards, he's got a shot. Centers it. Knocked away. There's a Jim Flairmont there on defense. Gordie Roberts again takes the puck back, passes it back to goal. Over to Bonin. Up to Toomey. Passes it up for Qualley. Tries to go back. Conrad has a heck of a save. Gets a glove on it. Anyway, Walls up with it. Toomey takes it away. Intercepted a short pass. Hendrickson gets up the ice in a hurry with Team White. Wes Walz meets him in the corner. Anyway, McAlpin's there and the nameless white shirt guy whose name I still haven't bothered to look up. I know you think all these famous NHL guys that recognize his face, but I can't pick his out. So it's got to look for a defenseman on here that doesn't have his or number. Anyway, puck gets clear of the white offensive zone. Dave Qualley knocks it back up in a hurry. White's changing though, can't take advantage. Down to 6 minutes left. White's up 10-7. All right, Walz sends the puck, comes into the defense, where he goes around both defenders and whiffs. Centers the pass. As Eggerstrom was there, couldn't get a shot up, and up into the glove of Dave Qualley. We get a stoppage in play. Oh, yeah, he went around both defenders. That's why he got paid the big bucks. Other fans in the mezzanine talking about the move Wes Walz just used to get around both defenders, one on two. Hey, Sam Kelly out with Gabe Thomas. Gabe sends it out for Sam, but Jerry Page in the middle. Pass was behind him. Pass went by Tom Chorski, who's looking disappointed that he couldn't handle it. Tom Youngins there with the puck. Loses it to the defense, and here comes Sam Kelly with Kowalska and Thomas. Danny Morrill on the ice now. Chris Price just kind of lost his foot. That's fitting. Anyway, Tom Chorski one-on-one with a back checker. And there was a goal that time. 8-6. He put Big Save Dave right on his butt that time. Dave couldn't handle it. Tom Chorski, I heard once, walked up behind Dave and said, "I smell goalies." Indeed you do. 10-8, Team White now ahead of Team Green. Anyway, Mandich with the puck now for Green, skates it into the zone, into the corner. Flairmont keeps it in on a loose puck, winds up, takes a shot, and Qualley found it through all the bodies. Good save by Big Save Dave. Keep it at 10-8. 3:50 now and counting down, running time for period number three. Still got a few hundred people here cheering on the Warriors and the NHL alumni. No lockout here today. Hey, Brian Bonin with a puck taken away by Andy Qualley, who's arguably the most talented of us. The Warriors, oh, he tries to take it in, had it blocked away. Heck of an acrobatic play there by Flairmont to get his hands on that puck. Canavan now into the offensive zone, passes it across the ice for Steller, who missed it. The puck was bouncing a bit. Anyway, puck was right on the blue line and now clear. Green has the clear, and they are. Pass up to Bonin, who gets around Andy Qualley. Puck bounces free, and Andy Qualley gets a hold of it. Passes it up now for, it's Gordie Roberts. Over to Engel, who couldn't handle it. Pushing and shoving going on in the corner, trying to get the puck out. Gordie Roberts, Wes Walz, Scott Canavan. Walz has the puck, bounces it around back. We found Steller, no look. Stonewalled by Dave Qualley. White still trying to clear the zone, and there it is. Payne knocks it free. Pete Staley there across the ice, pass for Walz. Well, waits for the offense to get set up, and there's Sam Kelly with going to the corner to get it, passes it back across the ice for Pete Staley. Couldn't handle it, and there was Lagstrom. And we lost a stick here, one of the White players, one of the White defenders, the nameless pro who's now looking for something to do. Oh, and a good play. Anixon had the puck. Passed it up for Kelly, who couldn't make the play. Knocked the net off. There's an open net now for Green. Sean Toomey's got it. Not really looking to take advantage of the open net. Just trying to skate around a bit. There's Wes Walz now with the puck coming up into the offensive zone. He's got Chorski to his left. Langenson now sitting on the back door. Centering pass out. There's McAlpin. Sean Toomey there, over to Payne, who sends it, and it's open net, empty netter. That'll make it 11-8 with 44 seconds to go and counting. I think we're going to have one more faceoff. Anyway, 30 seconds now to go. Team Green has just emptied the bench. Everybody's coming out on the ice for Green. And everybody on the White, and a goal for Green. Just having a little bit of fun. There's Joe Scavel. Trying to pick a fight with a bigger Jerry Page. But I think that's going to be it. So we've had a good time. Second annual Minnesota Warriors NHL Alumni Association fundraising event. Final score, if it matters, Team White 11, Team Green 8. And I already can't wait to do this again next year.
So I'm Chris Walden from Minnesota Warriors and CheapSeatsAmen.com. I say thanks for joining the View for the Cheap Seats. Support your troops and come out to see these Warriors play. Come cheer them on next time you get a chance, guys. Later.